You are sitting next to the most powerful position in the world.
You could very well make the argument that White House Chief of Staff is the second most powerful job in government.
Being the White House Chief of Staff in the Ford presidency was unquestionably the toughest job I ever had.
The White House is West Wing without a script.
The White House Chief of Staff is the one person who can look him right in the eye and say, you simply can't go down that road.
If the president gets woken up in the middle of the night to address a challenge, the Chief of Staff has already been awake for many, many hours dealing with that very challenge.
You have a house, oversized, with higher walls than normal, no internet connection, and they burn their trash. Do you think a judge in the United States would give you a search warrant based on that data?
Tonight, I can report to the American people and to the world that the United States has conducted an operation that killed Osama bin Laden, the leader of Al-Qaeda.
As we came over the White House, President Reagan leaned over, looked down, and tapped Nancy on her knee and said, look, dear, there's our little bungalow. And that's the moment that everybody started tearing up.
It brought back vivid memories to me, but I'm sure that because of my experience, they probably just doubled up so that they wouldn't make the same mistake that I made.
We started the day around 7 o'clock in the president's bedroom. He conducted business from the bed for 2 or 3 hours.
President Bush developed what he called the Scowcroft Award.
If you fall asleep in an organized meeting around the cabinet table, for example, then you're awarded this coveted prize.
And he had a very complicated process of awarding points for where you fell asleep, how deeply you fell asleep, how smoothly you recovered.
Chief of Staff's job has more authority and more power, if you want to put it in those terms, than the vice president.
As shocking a decision as he had just had to make, he went around after that meeting and I saw him giving them reassurance, saying, we're doing the right thing, we'll get through this.
Would you trade it in and not have done it? And I guarantee to every chief of staff, U.S., they said I would do it again if asked.